Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with a brand new Let's Play. This time it's of Total War Warhammer on that there PC. Yes, for those of you who do not know, Total War Warhammer is the most recent entry in the well-known, the acclaimed Total War series of strategy games, relatively realistic strategy games. Unlike every other part of the Total War series, however, Total War Warhammer takes place in the universe of Warhammer Fantasy. I'm a big fan of Warhammer, both Fantasy and 40K, though I'm more familiar with 40K. I'm a big fan of Warhammer, and I'm a big fan of Total War, and putting the two together has just made genuinely what I think is one of my all-time favorite games. It's been a while since I've loved a game quite as much as I've been loving Total War Warhammer. Before I begin, I'm going to give you a couple of warnings right now. This is not the vanilla game. You can probably tell this quite a lot by the fact that this doesn't say Total War Warhammer. It says the Radius Total War mod. I have quite a long list of mods installed. I'm not going to go through all of them. Suffice it to say, by and large, they are aesthetic mods. I normally play with a mod that was released basically as soon as the game came out, which allows you to conquer everything. I'm not doing that this time, just for... well, frankly, for ease, because if I want to be playing for a ludicrously long amount of time, fine, let everyone conquer everything. However, this is a Let's Play, and I don't want to be chasing one faction around as it basically inhabits every possible place it can and gets massively out of control. So, yeah, there you go. Of the mods that do actually add new gameplay, obviously there is the Radius Total War mod, which fundamentally changes the way that this game plays for the better, I think. It makes it a much more visceral kind of combat. You get a lot more kills. One of the biggest complaints a lot of people and myself had for the way this game played was that the armies routed entirely too easily, especially for the Warhammer setting. With Radius, that's not an issue anymore. The Radius Total War, it adds a load of things, including campaign balance and economy balancing and combat balancing and attack frequency. It adds a load of things. And there's also the Radius Total War unit pack, which adds a bunch of new units to every faction. Most of which are, if not lore-friendly, they are plausible, and plausibility is all I really care about. I mean, I suppose plausible does mean lore-friendly. I mean, they add a lot of units that aren't in the tabletop, but you could plausibly believe would exist for the faction. Other than that, it's basically exclusively aesthetic mods. Right, so I'm gonna start a new campaign here. You may notice here that they're not, other than the Beastmen, these aren't actually named as their race, but we've got Reichland, which is the Empire, Karazakarak, which is the Dwarves, Broken Tooth, which is the Greenskins, Sylvania, which is the Vampire Counts, and Chaos Undivided, which is the Warriors of Chaos. We are going to be playing as the Greenskins, my favorite race in both Warhammer Fantasy and 40K, because frankly, they are silly fucking assholes. So we're going to be playing as them. We're going to be going for the short campaign victory, which I believe, yep, we have to destroy all the orc factions, basically, so we are the only orcs around. We have to occupy and loot or sack that many settlements, and also destroy the Empire and the Dwarves. Yes, what the fuck is the difference between, if we have to kill those as well, what's the difference between, that's the difference. Right, in this we just have to destroy that one particular part of the Dwarves, whereas in the other one, we have to quite literally destroy every orc. We have to take over the entirety of the orc, of the Dwarven area. That's understandable. Right, I'm trying to think of any other mods I should warn you about. Oh yes, I have a mod, at some point during the campaign, Chaos starts invading. Every time I played this game, it happened way too early for me to be ready for it, so I have a mod that puts that off a bit. I'm fairly certain we should still run into Chaos, but it won't be at the time we normally do. Okay, let's begin. First of all, we're going to pick our leader. We can pick between Azag the Slaughterer and Grimgor Ironhide. I like Azag the Slaughterer conceptually. If you don't know, you don't know who Azag the Slaughterer is, he's basically, although I believe in the lore, he should arguably be dead at this point, but then again, exactly when this game takes place is a bit vague. Azag the Slaughterer is, he is a melee, well obviously he's melee focused, he's a massive orc, he's a melee focused character, who is also a, I believe he's a death sorcerer, due to, when you see him, you'll see he's got quite an unusual headpiece there, that the crown of sorcery created by the ancient sorcerer Nagash, the father of necromancy, and that gives him magical powers. The issue is, in order to actually use any of his magic, we need to get all of his artifacts, all of his like special quests, and I don't really do those. So essentially what we have is a slightly less efficient version of Grimgar Ironhide. I'm going to be playing as Grimgar Ironhide simply because it's easy enough to get magic in this game. As the orcs, it's not that hard, and quite frankly, Grimgar Ironhide is too fucking useful, because he's almost a siege engine in and of himself. He is ridiculous. He's absolutely fucking ridiculous. So, I'm gonna be playing as Grimgar Ironhide. I did just remember, actually, I have a mod that gives, unit, like, lords and heroes that shouldn't have mounts. Mounts. Or that didn't have mounts in the base game. Mounts. Because it doesn't make sense to me that so many of them don't have mounts. Right. Let's start the campaign. I think I'm going to shut up while it's going through this introduction.
War comes. I can smell it. The old world teeters on a blade's edge, but a steadying hand may yet save it. Is that my role? Alas, nothing as grand. I am merely a humble advisor to Grimgar Ironhide, the most brutal of black orcs. Even that bestial intellect recognized a use in me. Now I accompany his horde as we travel south, laying waste to the stunted and rival orc tribes alike. Deep in the Badlands, Gorfang Rotgut, master of Black Crag, challenges his superiority. Grimgar stands to take the whole of the old world as his prize. The first, he must vanquish Rotgut and take Black Crag as his new capital.
However, all that shit about Black Crag isn't relevant because we're not doing the introduction. Yeah, I don't know why, but, oh, I also have modded loading screens. Anyway, I've modded this game. I have a lot of mods. I also have a mod for the blood. Actually, to make the blood more reasonable. Anyway, but yeah, no. The Black Crag. Fuck it. We just start with Black Crag. For the simple reason that we're not doing the introduction. For some reason, every single, I think all of the main factions, barring, okay, every one of the base game factions, barring the DLC factions of Chaos Undivided and the Warriors of Chaos and the Beastmen, have an optional faction introduction. Which is basically a tutorial. I think it's always a siege battle that's a tutorial battle. That teaches you how the game works. Thankfully, I already know how the game works, though that's no indication I'll be good. So we're not doing it, so we're just going to start with the Black Crag. I assume that the reason Chaos... the Warriors of Chaos and the Beastmen don't have it is because if you're playing a... You know... the Warriors of Chaos are the only hard difficulty faction, so if you're playing them, then probably you know what you're doing. And with the Beastmen, they were a DLC faction. Like, you know, at the very least with the Warriors of Chaos, there's a chance that you might have had them upon release. You know, because I think it was for the first, like, week or so of the game's release, you had it. They were just free for everyone who bought it. And with the Beastmen, that's like a £15 DLC. So presumably, if you're dropping £15 on them, you've played the game. So, yeah, it's fine. Also, yes, this game takes a while to load. I think it's the initial load of the campaign. It takes a while to load. After that, especially with the fact that I upgraded my PC recently, it doesn't take anywhere near as long to load. And yes, I'm aware, some people are actually asking me, they're asking me sideways, why haven't you done Warhammer Total War, or Total War Warhammer yet? Because you clearly love it. And some of you, those of you who watch my podcast, the relatively short-lived Two Gents Who Hate Each Other podcast, will know that I was constantly going on about this, like, leading
Black
up to its release
Crag
and afterwards.
Is yours, my brutal lord. The Badlands beyond lay open for conquest. This area is dominated by tribes of inferior greenskins. On the plains to the west, Rotguts, Red Fangs mass against you, angry at the loss of their stronghold. Proving your utter superiority over Gorfang should be your first calling. Vanquish the Red Fang, and tribes of lesser orcs will flock to your banner, freeing your mobs to look further afield for lands to conquer. The stunted dwarfs that dwell in the mountains around you should provide plentiful quarry. Your enemies are belligerent and won't necessarily cow down to your indomitable will. They need to be tamed, broken, or annihilated.
Sorry, this guy is the closest thing we have to a story, so I don't want to talk over him. But yeah, no, the reason I never covered this until now, I was speaking of yet another mod that, it should have, although, is it not working right now? Wait, let me... Oh, that's upsetting. Maybe I accidentally uninstalled it. I had a mod that changed, the money in this game to, teeth, because, for those of you who don't know, orcs use teeth as their currency. Anyway, yeah, the reason I'd never covered this game, I never made a Let's Play this game or anything until now, is it's fairly simple. It's my PC, can only barely handle it. It's the main problem. Yeah, that was it. My PC could barely handle the game, and I didn't want to be playing it when it ran like shit on low settings, whereas currently it runs fairly well on high settings. Right, so, yeah, I'm just gonna go through a, gonna fight. Wait, didn't it say that this is Gorfang Rotgut? Why are we fighting Nash, and why does he look exactly like Gorfang Rotgut? Whatever. Right, so, we're gonna fight. Should explain right away, actually. Thing I just noticed. For most factions, this doesn't come into it until you've had a couple of fights. But yeah, this game has a banner system. I can't remember if it was in any of the other games. Essentially, banners are status effects you can apply to certain units, and as long as that unit remains alive and you keep the banner on it, it will keep that. For example, a Grimgor starts with the banner De Immortals, because those of you who don't know, Grimgor Ironhide is a black orc, a particularly big and brutal kind of orc, and he has a number of really quite strong, famously potent black orc bodyguards called Da Immortals. So yeah, you can give a thing to just make the Black Orc unit you start with pretty impressive. Of course, if you aren't aware, for every faction leader, every legendary lord you begin with, you actually get a different loadout of units in your first go round. Typically, it tends to be a handful of late game units. In fact, you can see I think I've got some Orc Boar Boys, which are unique to Grimgor, at least unique to him this early in the game. I got a is that a Doom Diver catapult? I think it is. And yeah, of course, my Black Orcs, all kind of late game units. The Black Orcs specifically are very good. Although the Doom Diver is ludicrously accurate. Like, It's really weird how accurate the Doom Diver catapult can be, given that it's quite literally. And I'll show you this when we get in, when we get into this fight. You can see it's quite literally just some fucking poor bastard goblins strapped to some wings and fired at the enemy. Let's zoom in here a bit. Where is my Doom Diver? We've got our ball boys there, but yeah, look, here's the Doom Diver. Yeah, do you see any ammunition? No, you don't, because the ammunition's the goblins. Right, let's get our formation sorted. God, I love black orcs. I just love how the orcs look in general, big spooky bastards, right? Well, not they're not spooky, are they? Right. The enemy? Oh, right, I'm not looking in their direction. Now you can see him, okay. Okay, what do these guys actually have? Ah, Goblin Wolf Chariot. Annoying little cunts. I hate the Goblin Wolf Chariot. Largely because for a long time, you don't really have anything. I've never figured out a decent way to deal with these. Like, I still don't know exactly what the best way to fight those off would be. Orc Arrow Boys, Goblin Archers, Goblins, Orc Boys. Yeah, these guys aren't really going to be a problem, are they? Okay. Well, I'll put the Orc Boys in the center there. Actually, no, I'm going to put the Immortals in the center there, because they're a lot, because they're rather tough, the Immortals. They can take quite a solid beating. I'm going to slap my Goblin Spearman up the side there. Largely, so if I need to, I can turn them round, and so they can, deal with those wolf chariots if they make the mistake of getting too close. Slap an archer back there. This is a fairly standard thing. As we go through this Let's Play, you'll see me doing this quite a lot. Just this kind of arms out towards the enemy kind of thing. Was he saying like brouhaha or ooh-ha-ha or something? Okay. Gonna have the Doom Diver there. Right, the Doom Diver, what I want you doing, my horrible little lunatic friend, is aiming at them. You chaps should begin moving up here. While you, my fine boys, can start pissing off up here. Thankfully, this is the Radius mod, so I believe that these chaps are liable to actually begin moving against me fairly early. That's one issue that I had with the base game that the Radius mod thankfully fixed. In the base game, when you start a fight, if you start the fight, the enemy just is happy to sit there. The enemy AI is happy to sit there until you engage them, as opposed to being sensible and attacking you fairly quickly. Like, yeah, I understand them, you know, starting a defensive formation. That makes sense. I just don't understand them not moving forward at all, like making no effort to harm you. Okay, yep, they're not getting there before those guys do, so I think we should, back up and hold our position. Since they seem so willing to attack me. Oh, no, you don't, Goblin Wolf Chariot. You don't get to attack. You don't get to attack my ball boys. Okay, good. That's chased them out of the way. And now I believe this is basically all we need to do. Just give the order and leg it at them, lads. And Grimgor's already covered in his own blood. Okay, I think, yep, these two lines of great warriors are going to meet, and Grimgor's gonna fucking smack them miles away. Yep, he is absolutely ridiculous. Can take out entire units on his own, can Grimgor Ironhide. And now, because these poor swine have no idea what they're doing, I'm gonna turn my boar boys around and have them smack these poor bastards in the face. Although, Yeah, you know what? I think... Yeah, these guys don't need any support, do they? Nah, they've got Grimgore and Black Orcs, they're fine. These poor bastards, however, could do with a bit of unexpected boring. Oh, there you go. Oh, poor little goblins, they're so small as well. Well, I don't think they need the boars anymore. Some more goblins need some boars! Eat it, you scrawny little gits! Come on! Must be said, of all the Total War games, I genuinely think that this game has by far the most satisfying combat. You know what I mean? Just because of how meaty everything in this game is. It just... You know, when things die, you feel them die. You know what I mean? Like, it looks like... It just looks grand. Everything about this game's combat is brilliant, frankly. Fuck up. Are these guys are fucking rallying. I'm not having that. You rest the goblins. You still outnumber them. Go stab them. Yeah, they... It's rare that things run away from goblins, but... On the occasion that they do. Right. They're running. And now there's something I need to do. I need to find their leader. There he is. Right. Just giving everyone the order to kick crap out of their leader. Just to make a point, really, I suppose. Oh, he's dead. Okay. Well, run them down, I suppose. I mean, if the dude's already dead, there's no other reason to not. There's no reason to not run him down. Please, Paladin. You know, it's not many games, not many strategy games actually make it very obvious how good an idea it is to run down your enemies, but the amount of times that I've ended up being fucked in the back by enemy armies that really should have been dead, who I chased off but then got bloodied by another enemy army, or they reinforced a new enemy army and just ended up ruining me, it's ridiculous. And yeah, if we actually look at the scene of the scrum there, you can see the one of my mods at work, the fact that there's blood on the ground. Something that always bugged me, the fact that there was no blood on the ground. Especially when you're playing as Chaos, when you're in a place, you know, where everything's like pure driven snow and you can have like 1,000 dudes all crushed up against each other, beating fuck out of each other, and yet somehow there's no blood on the floor. Makes no sense. Like, there'd be blood all over the shop. You know what? I think I'm getting as many of them as I am, though. Let's end that. Decisive victory? Well, I should fucking hope so. We lost 24 guys. And let me guess, of them, yep, basically all goblins. As I expected. Yeah, lost 230. You see, that's the greatness of the Radius mod, that the fact that they lost so many people, that my Boar Boys got like 82 kills, my Black Ox got 46. Like, you don't get numbers like that unless you use the Radius mod, because most of the time everyone fucking runs away before you get any kind of actual killing done. And yeah, this makes me sound like a psychopath, but god damn it, it's Warhammer! It's a fucking grim, violent setting. You need blood and you need death. It's how it goes. Like, if everyone just runs away, you can't have, like, that moment if you're playing as the Empire fighting off Chaos and the Orcs, where there's just monsters everywhere and your men are just desperately holding ground. You can't have that moment. Unless you have a mod that makes them stop running. Okay. At the end of every fight, where we're fighting a general and not a settlement, we have three options. We have ransom captives, which lowers our fightiness level, and yeah, you can see it calls it Teeth, it's just the icon isn't playing. Huh. Maybe the mod's gone weird? I don't know, I'll check it between recordings. But there you go, we can get some extra Teeth for ransoming them. It could be a good idea, but It's just not orky enough.
Right. We have slaughter captives. Ah, that's pretty orky. You know, murder them. That's fine. Give us some extra leadership so we got better morale for a few turns.
Or we could eat the bastards. Which is an incredibly orky option, and the one I basically always take. Because greenskins... Because greenskins aren't averse to eating other greenskins. In fact, they quite like it. Another part of the mod, of the radius mod here. Rather than 1 point per level up, we get 2. Which is incredibly good. Now, yeah, I tend to spend a lot of my time down here. Is there anything we really need? Warpath. You know, it occurs to me, I may only spend a lot of my time down here because I have played Chaos and the Beastmen for so long, and the hordes kind of require you to spend a lot of time down there because that's the only way you can kind of get better infrastructure, or air quotes, infrastructure. Well, we can't go any further. Get into a raiding camp as well. Just make ourselves some money feeding off of the wealth of their area while we get our troops back. Yeah, it was basically all goblins we lost, wasn't it? Yeah, because we just need one more of them. Oh, also, I should explain this, actually. Sorry, I'm trying to explain all the combat here, all the mechanics. Unique to the orcs and the beastmen is a fightiness meter. Although, for the beastmen, I believe it's called the bestial rage mechanic. Basically, orc armies and orc generals have to be fighting almost constantly, because as orcs are wont to do, if they don't have enough enemies to fight, they will start fighting each other. That doesn't necessarily explain how an orc general on his own will start taking health damage from low fightiness. Never understood that one myself. But if we're dealing with large scale armies like Grimgors here, or just armies, large collections of greenskins, they will start eating and killing each other if we don't give them something else to bash. This is shown by the fightiness mechanic, where essentially we have to keep raiding and pillaging and fighting and burning in order to keep this fightiness meter here nice in the middle. We start going too low into unruly, problems start to happen, and we start getting attrition. Indeed. Although, thankfully, we do actually have a button that will show up down here if we get too low, which basically gets the, which is basically the button, called, I believe it's called Quell Animosity, that causes the war boss to take a walk around his lads, beating up troublemakers. Does lead to some immediate attrition, but can save you in a pinch. And if we get above here, forget to say the very top, we will spawn something known as a war. I want to give it the proper pronunciation, a war, which in this game is an AI-controlled allied army that will follow around whichever army caused it to spawn and reinforce them. And they tend to be very powerful. Indeed, they are. They're why orcs can be so frightening in this game, because once they get a good few fights under their belt, they have a very solid chance of essentially steamrolling you. What do we need to bring here? Oh, we need to build the Shaman Hut's building. Right. Well, I've spent half an hour talking, and I've only just completed turn one. Isn't that great? Oh. Oh dear. Oh dear, we're being attacked. But I think we're gonna have to deal with this attack in the next video. Give it a quick save there. That's gonna have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Sardis Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.